हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू ग्लोबल ऑनलाइन यूनिवर्सिटी। आई एम बाहुबली देसाई एंड ड्यूरिंग दिस लॉकडाउन पीरियड आई होप यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग वेल फॉर योर एग्जामिनेशन एंड आई होप यू आर स्टेइंग एट होम विथ आवर ग्लोबल ऑनलाइन यूनिवर्सिटी। एंड फ्रेंड्स, डोंट स्टॉप योर स्टडी ड्यूरिंग दिस लॉकडाउन पीरियड। फॉर दिस पर्पज वी हैव बीन प्रोवाइडिंग यू various mock test series, and we have already released the schedule of our mock test series, and I hope you have enrolled for this mock test series. And also, to assess your preparation, we are also providing mock test series in the video format also, and I think this is our 13th mock test series in the video format. Friends, whenever a question appears on the screen, pause the video and try to answer the question, then you can check the correct answer. Friends, also we have released the schedule of our mock test series. Please enroll to that mock test series, and I hope those mock test series will bring more success in your examination, and those mock tests are prepared in a very well manner, and those mock tests will boost your preparation. And friends, some of you have confusion between these video mock test series and those mock test series. Friends, these video mock test series are different and those mock test series are different. Those 20 mock test series you are getting in a PDF format, and you have to go to our website and you have to open that mock test series, and you have to answer the question, and the responses you will get to your Gmail account. That mock test will be held according to the NTA NET examination, and we have already released the mock test series. On people and environment we have provided, on communication we have released, and on ICT and also on teaching aptitude the mock tests have been released, and our next mock test is releasing on higher education. And till your examination we will provide you at least 20 mock test series, and to get all these 20 mock test series you have to enroll to our Global Online University website. And friends, all these mock tests are available only at ₹99. It is very less amount, friends. Please enroll first, and if you enroll now also you can get all previous 4 mock tests. Okay, let us start. When you complete your maths exercise, you can play the computer game using such kind of reinforcement, wherein students' favorite activity can be used to reinforce a student's engagement in a less popular activity is termed as frenzy. For an example, when a student want to play some game, but a parent will tell that first you complete this study or study for half an hour, then you can play. This trick is termed as option A, Premack principle, option B, Thorndike law, option C, Pavlov experiment, option D, none of the above. Friends, it is known as the Premack principle. I hope you understood this. Now we'll see what is Premack principle. Friends, Premack principle, it is a principle of reinforcement which states that an opportunity to engage in more probable behaviors or activities will reinforce less probable activities. For example, if a child enjoys playing computer games and avoids completing math problem, we might allow her to play the computer after completing 15 math problems. For example, other example, when a child wants to play in the garden, when a child wants to watch cartoon but he doesn't want to study, then what a parent will do, first allow him to complete his study at least for half an hour, then If a parent allow the child to watch cartoon, a child will definitely complete his study and then he will watch the cartoon. This method is known as the PREMAC principle. I hope you understood this. Now the next question is, how the students should be motivated to get success in life? Option A, selective study. Option B, incidental study. Option C, intensive study. Option D, rote learning. Friends, here the right answer is option C, intensive study. Should be motivated to get success. Next question is, suggestions for lecture listening include suggestions for lecture listening. Option A, focusing on the delivery part and avoiding summarizing and reviewing the information. Option B, poor attention in order to think creatively, listening for details and ignoring lecture cues. Option C, not to make notes so as to focus better on lecture and message delivery. Option D, finding areas of interest to you, avoiding distractions and listening for main ideas. Friends, here the right answer is option D, to develop listening skill. Option D, finding areas of interest to you, then avoid the distraction and also listen for the main ideas carefully. So option D is the correct answer. I hope you understood this. Now the next question is, what is more desirable in a classroom? Option A, a teacher delivering a lecture on the basis of the text and his own research. Option B, a teacher delivering a lecture on the basis of course content and standard books. No. Option C, a teacher answering questions raised by students. Option D, a teacher maintaining strict discipline and taking attendance regularly. No, this doesn't work. So here the correct answer is option A, a teacher delivering a lecture on the basis of text and also on the basis of his own research. See, for example, whenever you go on reading the textbook, students may become passive, but when a teacher will deliver the lecture by using the text and also by our own notes and also by telling some new things, students will be more active. So option A is the correct answer. It is the more desirable in a classroom. Now we'll go to the next question. If students do not understand what is taught in the classroom, the teacher should feel, option A, terribly bored. No, to explain it in a different way. C, then that he is wasting time. No, it is not correct. Option D, pity for the students. No, teacher should not feel pity for the students. What a teacher has to do, if the students are not understanding, she has to find different ways to explain it. So option B is the correct answer. When students do not understand, teacher has to find another way to explain it. Now we'll go to the next question. Which of the following can be described as the most probable characteristic of an ineffective teacher? Option A, always focus on achievement of instructional objectives. Option B, always focus on observance of teaching standards. Option C, always focus upon control of immediate situation. Option D, none of the above. Friends, most probable characteristic of an ineffective teacher, always focus upon control of immediate situation. So option C is the correct answer. I hope you understood this. Now the next question is, which one of the following is appropriate with respect to teacher-student relationship? Option A, very informal and intimate. No, limited to classroom only. No, option C, cordial and respectful. Option D, indifferent. So option C, cordial and respectful is the correct answer. Now the next question is, a time-bound testing program for students should be implemented in school so that option A, the progress of the students should be informed to their parents. Option B, a regular practice can be carried out. ऑप्शन सी द स्टूडेंट्स कैन बी ट्रेन्ड फॉर फाइनल एग्जामिनेशन, ऑप्शन डी द रेमिडियल प्रोग्राम कैन बी अडॉप्टेड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द फीडबैक फ्रॉम द स्टूडेंट्स. फ्रेंड्स अ टाइम बाउंड टेस्टिंग, ऑप्शन डी द रेमिडियल प्रोग्राम कैन बी अडॉप्टेड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द फीडबैक फ्रॉम द स्टूडेंट्स. सो ऑप्शन डी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. नेक्स्ट नेशनल काउंसिल ऑफ एजुकेशनल रिसर्च एंड ट्रेनिंग NCERT वॉज एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन ऑप्शन ए 1961, ऑप्शन बी 1962, ऑप्शन सी 1963, ऑप्शन डी 1964. फ्रेंड्स NCERT एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन, आई होप यू ऑल नो दिस आंसर, ऑप्शन ए 1961. The NCERT is known stands for National Council of Educational Research and Training. It is an autonomous organization established by the Government of India in the year of 1961. Its headquarters is in New Delhi. Director of NCERT is Dr. Hrushikesh Senapati. Founder Government of India in the year of 1961. The current president is Ramesh Pokhriyal. Friends, the next question is the success of integrated education depends on option A the support of community, option B excellence of textbooks, option C the highest quality of teaching learning material, option D attitudinal changes in teachers. Friends, this question is for you. You have to answer this. First, see what is integrated education. Then you can give the answer. Please comment the answer in the comment box. Friends, physiological noise. It is distraction due to physiological function. For example, headache, hunger, pain. These are the physiological noise in the communication. I hope you understood this. Now the next question is, which of the following will make communication more effective? Option A, cracking jokes in between. No, it is not the correct answer. Option B, using multi-sensory appeal. Option C, speaking with high authority. Option D, telling what is useful to the listeners. Friends, effective communication. So option B, using multi-sensory appeal is the right answer. Now let us go to the next question. Non-verbal cues, leakage cues. Okay, I hope you understood this. Okay, leakage cues means you understood, no? It occurs when a person is telling something but his body language is showing and something else. Now let us go to the next question. In communication, connotative words are option A, explicit, option B, abstract, option C, simple, option D, cultural. Friends, here the right answer is connotative words are cultural. So option D is the correct answer. Friends, the next question is, a sender in communication process has very good grammar. This competence is basically option A, phonemic, option B, semantic, option C, syntactic, option D, pragmatic. Friends, a sender in communication process has very good grammar. It is a syntactic in communication. Friends, the next question will be, journal-like entries written by individuals and posted on the internet that sometimes can generate many online discussions. Option A, weblogs, weblogs. Option B, simple posting. Option C, e-journals. Option D, none of the above. Friends, the right answer is option A, weblogs. Web blogs, okay. And a blog is a discussion or informational website published on the World Wide Web, and it is consisting discrete, often informal diary style text entries. And posts are also typically displayed in reverse chronological order, so that the most recent post appears first at the top of the web page. I hope you understood about the blog. Now we'll move to the next question. If a student raises a hand to speak in a class, the person is using option A, modifier, option B, emblem, option C, regulator, option D, display. Friends, the right answer is option B, emblem. When a student raises his hand to speak in a class, it means the student is using emblem. And emblems are non-verbal signs that can generally be translated directly into words. Most people within a culture or group agree on their meaning. For example, when a teacher asks question, if a student raises his hand, means a teacher will understand this student is knowing the answer. In this way, in emblem, non-verbal signals will be converted into words. So I think you understood this. Now we'll move to the next question. The goal of perception checking is option A, confirmation, option B, cultural sensitivity, option C, to further explore the thoughts and feelings of others, option D, control. Friends, the goal of perception checking, here the correct answer is option C, to further explore the thoughts and feelings of others. And perception is a universal, yet it is also individual process, and each person will experience this perception checking and also interprets the word differently from others. Now the next question is, the most powerful barrier of communication in the class is option A, noise in the classroom, option B, confusion on the part of teacher, option C, more outside disturbance in the classroom, option D, lack of teaching aids. Friends, all these options are barrier to the communication, but we have to choose which is the most powerful barrier of communication. So here most powerful barrier is confusion on the part of teacher. So option B is the correct answer. Confusion on the part of teacher, it is the most powerful barrier of communication. Now the next question is, writing in a personal diary or otherwise recording one's thoughts and feelings are examples of option A, mediated intrapersonal communication, option B, mediated interpersonal communication, option C, mediated mass communication, option D, none of the above. Friends, writing in a personal diary or recording one's thoughts or one's feelings are example of mediated intrapersonal communication. Intrapersonal means a person who is communicating with himself only. When he is writing a personal diary or recording his own thoughts or feelings, it means it is known as the intrapersonal communication. So correct answer will be option A, mediated intrapersonal communication. Now the next question. Intrapersonal communication is a communication within himself, or it is a communicator's internal use of language. It can be useful to intrapersonal communication occurring in the mind of the individual in a model which contains a sender, receiver and also feedback. I hope you understood this. Now let us go to the next question. Friends, the next question is, media that exist in an interconnected series of communication points are referred to as option A, networked media, option B, connective media, option C, nodal media, option D, multimedia. Friends, media that exist in an interconnected series of communication is known as the networked media. So option A is the correct answer. Friends, I hope you understood this. Friends, the next question is, how many members of the Rajya Sabha are nominated by the President of India? Option A, 10, option B, 12, option C, 15, option D, 18. Friends, the right answer is option B, 12. फ्रेंड द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन प्रोवाइड्स दैट राज्यसभा शैल कंसिस्ट 250 मेंबर्स ऑफ विच मेंबर्स 12 मेंबर्स शैल बी नॉमिनेटेड बाय द प्रेसिडेंट एंड व्हाइल नॉमिनेटिंग द मेंबर्स प्रेसिडेंट विल कंसिडर स्पेशल नॉलेज प्रैक्टिकल एक्सपीरियंस इन रेस्पेक्ट ऑफ लाइक लिटरेचर साइंस आर्ट सोशल साइंस एंड रिमेनिंग 238 रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स will represent the state and the union territories. And remember one more point, in Rajya Sabha the election is indirect, and at present Rajya Sabha has 245 seats. Of these seats, 233 members represent the states and union territories, and 12 members are nominated by the president. I hope you understood. Now the next question is, which of the following non-members of parliament has the right to address it? Friends, which of the following non-member of parliament has the right to address? Option A, the chief election commissioner. Option B, the comptroller and auditor general, CAG. Then C, the attorney general of India. D, the solicitor general of India. Friends, the right answer is option C, the attorney general of India. He can address the parliament. Now the next question is, the 15th and current attorney general is KK Venugopal. He was appointed by the Pranab Mukherjee. He was formally appointed as with effect from 30 June 2017 and shall have a tenure of 3 years. Friends, the next question is, CAG is the chief accountant and auditor for option A, union government, option B, state government, option C, union and state government, option D, neither union nor state government. Friends, the right answer is option C, union and state governments. Friends, CAG of India is an authority established by Article 148 of Constitution of India, and CAG will audit all receipts and expenditure of the government of India. And CAG is also the external auditor of government-owned corporations and conducts audit of government companies also. Please remember all these points. Now we'll go to the next question. Match the following. List 1 is showing us institutions. List 2 is showing us functions. Option A, in institutions, parliament, C and AG, Ministry of Finance, executing departments. List 2, formulation of budget, enactment of budget, implementation of budget, legality of expenditure, justification of income. Friends, the right answer is option B. Parliament, the main function of parliament is enactment of budget. C and AG, the function is legality of expenditure. Then Ministry of Finance, formulation of budget. Then executing department, implementation of budget. Please remember all these points. Now we'll move to the next question. Prime Minister resigns when he does not command majority in the lower house of parliament. This is option A, in accordance with a stipulation in the constitution. Option B, not explicitly stated in the constitution but followed as a convention. Option C, peculiar to Indian democracy. Option D, a legacy of the Government of India Act 1919. Friends, the right answer is in accordance with a stipulation in the constitution. Now the next question is, right to education, which is known as the RTE Act, makes it mandatory to provide pre and compulsory education for children age between option A 6 to 14, option B 6 to 12, option C 8 to 14, option D none of the above. Friends, this is a very easy level question, but sometimes we won't remember. So here the right answer is option A, 6 to 14 years children, for them right RTE will apply. Friends, right of children to pre and compulsory education, RTE Act, it is the Act of Parliament of India enacted implemented on 4th August 2009 and it will describe the importance of pre and compulsory education for children between 6 and 14 and it comes under the article 21A and India became one of the 135th countries to make education a fundamental right of every child. Please remember this. And this act came into force on 1st April 2010. I hope you will remember all these points. Now we'll move to the next question. Which of the following amendments relates to the local government institutions? Option A, 52nd Amendment. Option B, 73rd Amendment. Option C, 66th Amendment. Option D, 17th Amendment. Friends, local government institutions related to 73rd Amendment. Please remember. Friends, the 73rd Amendment is about rural local governments. And also it is known as the Panchayat Raj institutions. And 74th amendment is related to urban local government, Nagarpalikas. Remember these points. Now we'll go to the next question. Which of the following authorities can impose reasonable restrictions on fundamental rights? Option A, the President. Option B, the Chief Justice of India. Option C, the Parliament. Option D, the Lok Sabha. Friends, the right answer is the President has authority to impose reasonable restrictions on fundamental rights. Friends, the next question is, which of the following age groups is taken into consideration for constituting gender parity index for higher education, GPI? Option A, 15 to 22. Option B, 18 to 23. Option C, 16 to 22. Option D, 18 to 25. Friends, the right answer is GPI. In higher education, it will constitute the age group between 18 to 23. Okay, GPI stands for Gender Parity Index in higher education. It is calculated for 18 to 23 years age group and it shows the ratio of the female to male in higher education. It measures the progress towards gender equity and the level of learning opportunities in relation to women to men. Friends, the next question is, how do directive principles of state policy differ from fundamental rights? Option A, the former are meant for union territories, whereas the latter are for states. Option B, the former are not enforceable, whereas the latter are enforceable. Option C, the former are not a part of the constitution, whereas the latter are the part of the constitution. Option D, none of the above. Friends, this question is for you. You have to answer this question in the comment box. Next question is, how does photochemical smog form? Option A, the release of primary air pollutants. Option B, interaction occurs between chemicals such as CFCs and ozone. Option C, reactions occur between secondary air pollutants and sunlight. Option D, the release of formaldehyde and radon inside buildings. Friends, here the right answer is option C, photochemical smog form reactions occur between secondary air pollutants and sunlight. I hope you knew this. Friends, photochemical smog, it is a mixture of pollutants that are formed when nitrogen oxides and volatile organic compounds react to sunlight, creating a brown haze above cities. Please remember this about photochemical smog. It is formed when nitrogen oxide and volatile organic compounds react to sunlight. I hope you understood this. Now the next question is, which of the following fuels are mainly responsible for release of lead into the environment? Option A, diesel. Option B, petrol. Option C, coal. Option D, all of the above. Friends, the right answer is option B, petrol. petrol is the fuel mainly responsible for release of lead into the environment. I hope you understood this. Now the next question is, match the following. List 1 is showing us water quality, list 2 is showing us pH value. Friends, options are neutral, option B moderately acidic, option C alkaline, option D injurious. And pH values are first one 5, second one 7, third one 4, fourth one 8. Friends, here the right answer is option C. Neutral water quality is having 5 pH value, moderately acidic is having 7 pH value, alkaline is having 8 pH value, and if the water is injurious, then its pH value is 4. I hope you understood this. Please remember these points. Now the next question is, global warming during winter becomes more pronounced at the option A equator, option B poles, option C Tropic of Cancer, option D Tropic of Capricorn. Friends, option D Tropic of Capricorn is the right answer. And Montreal Protocol signed in 1987 was signed to option A phase out the use of CFCs which cause depletion of the ozone layer, option B reduce the greenhouse effect, option C protect endangered species, option D ban nuclear testing in tropical oceans. Friends, the right answer is option A, phase out the use of CFCs which cause depletion of the ozone layer. Friends, the Montreal Protocol on substances that deplete the ozone layer. The Montreal Protocol is an international agreement designed to protect the stratospheric ozone layer. And the treaty was originally signed in 1987 and substantially amended in 1990 and 1992. So Montreal Protocol is related to ozone depletion. I hope you understood this. Now the next question is, the rules pertaining to biomedical waste are notified under, in India, option A Environmental Protection Act 1980, option B Environmental Act 1983, option C Environmental Act 1986, option D Environmental Act 1988. Friends, the right answer is option C, Environmental Protection Act 1986, related to biomedical waste in India. Environmental Protection Act 1986, it is an act of the Parliament of India, and it is the wake up of Bhopal tragedy, and it is enacted under the Environment Protection Act 1986 under Article 253 of the Constitution, and it has 26 sections and 4 chapters. The purpose of the act is to implement the decision of the United Nations Conference on the Human Environment. I hope you know this. You can read this information. And now the next question is, deforestation leads to an increase in atmospheric carbon dioxide because option A decaying trees release carbon dioxide, option B living trees remove carbon dioxide from the atmospheric via photosynthesis, option C burning wood releases carbon dioxide into the atmosphere, option D all of the above. Friends, deforestation, cutting the trees, leads to increase in the atmospheric carbon dioxide because option D all of the above. Because when we cut the trees, it means it will release the carbon dioxide. If we did not cut the trees, means living trees remove carbon dioxide from the atmosphere via photosynthesis. It is also right. So, and burning the wood also releases carbon dioxide into the air. So, option D is the right answer. Now, the next question is, chemical weathering of rocks is largely dependent on option A high temperature, option B strong wind action, option C heavy rainfall, option D glaciation. Friends, here the right answer is option A high temperature. Next question is, which of the following soils is very hard to cultivate? Option A alluvial soil, option B red soil, option C cotton soil, option D sandy soil. Friends, option B red soil is very hard to cultivate. Here you are seeing the picture of red soil. Red soil is a type of soil that develops in a warm temperature, moist climate under deciduous or mixed forests. and that have thin organic and organic mineral layers. Please remember these points. And red soil generally derived from crystalline rock. Remember this. A question may come from here. Now the next question is, the production of nuclear energy. Option A follows Einstein's principle of conversion of mass into energy. Option B is not ultimately derived from the sun's energy. Option C, both A and B. Option D, none of the above. Friend, this question you have to answer in the comment box. Which of the following statements is correct? About modem, option A, modem is a software. Option B, modem helps in stabilizing the voltage. Option C, modem is an operating system. Option D, modem converts analog signals into digital and vice versa. Friends, about modem, option D is the right answer. What modem will do? Modem will convert digital information to analog information and also analog signals back into digital information. Modem stands for modulator demodulator. Remember this. Next question. If you want to create a broadcast that can be downloaded from the internet, what would you create? Option A, iBroadcast. Option B, eShow. Option C, podcast. Option C, iCast. Friends, right answer is option C, podcast. A podcast is an episodic series of spoken word digital audio files that a user can download to a personal device for easy listening. Friends, the next question is, it is a very high-speed data transmission line that provides networking facilities to relatively small but high-speed internet service providers all around the world. It is called as option A, pathway, option B, backbone, option C, communication system, option D, router. Friends, it is known as the backbone. Option B is the right answer. Next question, using websites to pour out one's grievances is called, option A, cyber venting, option B, cyber ranting, option C, web hate, option D, web plea. Friends, the right answer is cyber venting. I hope you know this. Friends, the next question is, World Wide Web, WWW, was invented by, option A, Bill Gates, option B, ARPANET, option C, Tim Berners-Lee, option D, Bill Rogers. Friends, who invented the WWW? Option C, Tim Berners-Lee. Friends, Tim Berners-Lee, he was an English scientist. He invented World Wide Web in 1989 and he wrote first web browser in 1990. Remember these points. The term used for open wireless technology for data exchange over short distance is option A, ISDN, option B, Bluetooth, option C, Wi-Fi, option D, none of the above. Friends, the right answer is option B, Bluetooth. Bluetooth is a technology used for exchanging data wirelessly over short distances. I hope you know this. Very easy level question. Now the next question is, which of the following denotes the internet hardware requirements? Option, first one, modem, B, hub, third one, bridge, fourth one, router, fifth one, gateway. These are all are known as the internet hardware requirements only. So, option D is the right answer. Modem, hub, bridge, router, gateway. These are internet hardwares. Now the next question is, which of the following are web browsers? First one, Internet Explorer. Second one, Mozilla Firefox. Third one, Opera. Fourth one, Safari. All these are internet web browsers only. Friends, option D is the right answer. Now the next question is, yes, MIME in the internet technology stands for, option A, Secure Multi-Purpose Internet Mail Extension. Option B, Secure Multimedia Internet Mail Extension. Option C, Simple Multi-Purpose इंटरनेट मेल एक्सटेंशन, ऑप्शन डी सिंपल मल्टीपर्पज इंटरनेट मेल एक्सटेंशन। फ्रेंड्स द राइट आंसर इज ऑप्शन ए सिक्योर मल्टीपर्पज इंटरनेट मेल एक्सटेंशन। आई होप यू नो दिस, यू कैन रिमेंबर, प्लीज रिमेंबर दिस, अ क्वेश्चन मे बी आस्क्ड फ्रॉम हियर। नाउ द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, फ्रेंड लास्ट क्वेश्चन इज फॉर यू, यू हैव टू आंसर द आंसर इट इन द कमेंट बॉक्स। द क्वेश्चन इज बिकॉज यू डिजर्व टू नो इज द पंच लाइन यूज्ड बाय ऑप्शन ए द टाइम्स ऑफ इंडिया, ऑप्शन बी द हिंदू, ऑप्शन सी इंडियन एक्सप्रेस, ऑप्शन डी हिंदुस्तान टाइम्स। इन विच न्यूज पेपर बिकॉज यू डिजर्व टू नो द पंच विल बी यूज, यू हैव टू आंसर इट इन द कमेंट बॉक्स। फ्रेंड्स थैंक यू वेरी मच, थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग दिस मॉक टेस्ट। I hope you have done well, and also comment your score in the comment box. Your score will help me to bring more and more questions. Thank you.